Hello students. So students, in the previous class in this chapter, that is heat, we were talking about the conduction. Conduction is what? Conduction basically happens in that of the solid where the transfer of the heat occur from the one particles to another. Actually here, the particles, they do not move, but they used to vibrate at its place and due to which the heat get transferred. In this one, students, in the last class, we were talking about the good conductor and poor conductor of heat and electricity, heat. So, good conductor means what? It means that is a conductor only in which we can say that those substances which allow heat to pass through them, they are called as the good conductor of heat. And those substances which do not allow heat to pass through them, they are called as the poor conductor of heat. So, good conductor of heat which allow heat to pass through them, poor conductor or insulator which do not allow heat to pass through them. Example of that of the good conductor is metal object is there, students, like that of the copper is there or aluminium is there. They are what? They are a very good conductor. Alloys, metal alloys like that of a stainless steel is there, or steel is there, or brass is there. They all are also very good conductor of heat. Silver is there, gold is there, they all are a very good conductor of a heat. So all the metals, since they allow heat to pass through them, that is why they are the good conductor. Poor conductor of heat is that which do not allow heat to pass through them. Okay, so example, plastics, wood, glass, paper, rubber. Okay, these all are what? These all are the different examples of the poor conductor of heat or insulators of heat. It is because of this reason, if we were talking about the uses of this good conductor or the poor conductor of the heat, so we have seen that the metal object like copper, aluminium, alloys, they are used for making the utensils. So utensils are basically made up of the metal alloys. Now, if we are talking about that of the utensils, so we have seen that they are made up of a steel, they are made up of a copper, they are made up of a aluminium, which made it a good conductor, which help it that when we will keep it on a gas flame, then what happened? It will become hot, it becomes heated. But the handles, the pan handle or the utensils handles are basically made up of a plastic. And the reason is that if we will use it, it will be easy for us to handle that of the utensils. And just because of that, they are made up of plastics. Now, if suppose we will discuss about that of the other examples, so mercury is a very good conductor. They are very sensitive to the heat, and due to which it receives the heat, get expand and help in telling the temperature of a person. So that is why it is used in the thermometer to measure the temperature of a person here, students. The next thing that we were talking about that of the poor conductor, that why do we wear the woolen clothes in winter? So basically I told you that since the woolen clothes, they used to trap the air, and this air do not allow the heat from our body to go outside, and just because of this only we can say that the heat will be, it does not passes or heat remain as it is. So when our body heat will not escape out, it will not go outside, so ultimately we will feel warm. So it is because that it will help in trapping the air and do not allow our heat to pass through it. Some of the other things are also there, student, and that is, if we have given choice, if we have a given choice in winter, given choice in winter of using either one thick woolen blanket, one thick woolen blanket, or two thin woolen blanket, two thin woolen blanket joined together two thin woolen blanket joined together out of these two which will you prefer to use which one you prefer to use this is a question students in which we have given a choice in which you have to use in winter season we have to use one thick woolen blanket or two thin woolen blanket Your answer will be that if it is a thick, so that will provide much more heat, so better we should prefer the one thick woolen blanket rather than using the two thin. No, we should prefer the two thin woolen blanket because what happened when there are two layer, so there is a space, there is a gap, and due to which it help in trapping more and more air. And ultimately, air is a poor conductor, so that will also not allow the heat to escape out. So we can say that instead of using one thick woolen blanket, we should prefer the two thin woolen blanket. Okay. So the reason that we can write it that it is because air get trapped. Air get trapped in between them, and this extra layer of trapped air. This extra layer of trapped air prevent the heat to escape, prevent our body heat from going away. Okay, so if we had given a choice in winter to wear either one thick woolen cloth or woolen blanket or taking the two thin woolen blanket, absolutely we will going to use the two thin woolen blanket instead of the one thick woolen blanket, student. Okay. Now, is it that we are only there who uses the blanket or in order to protect us from winter? What about the birds? What about the other animals? How they use to protect themselves? So, we can write here that the feathers of the bird, in case of a bird, the feathers of the bird, feathers of the bird keep them warm
keep them warm. In cold weather, due to air trapped in them. So the feather of a bird which keeps them warm, that will help them to protecting them from that of the cold weather. Actually, the feather of the air, they used to trap the air, students. And again, we are knowing that air is a poor conductor, so it will not allow the heat, their body heat, to come outside, and ultimately that will help in protecting the cold from the surrounding, and so this will help in preventing the escape from the cold surrounding. Okay, so we can say here that it is the feather of the bird that helps them to survive even the condition, even the surrounding is cold. So let me write few points regarding that. That is, air being the poor conductor, prevents the body heat, prevents the body heat. From escaping to the cold surrounding. Escaping from the cold surrounding. Okay, and hence keeps the bird warm. Thus it keeps the bird warm. So the feather of the bird, it keeps them warm in the cold weather, and due to that, because of the air is trapped in them. And we can see here one more thing, that the air, it is a poor conductor, so it get prevented, the heat which is present there get prevented from the body to escape out, and ultimately this will protect them from the cold surrounding. Okay, so this is how the feather of the bird helps them in protecting them from the cold surrounding. What about the other animals, students? So the other animals are also having fur on their body. You have seen, especially in the cold climate, in the hilly region or the polar region, the animals which are surviving there, which are living there, they all are having the fur on their body, and this fur help in preventing the cold. Okay, animals in cold region, are having fur, which helps in trapping the air and thus preventing the cold from surrounding. Here you have seen, student, that these days the cold or the hot, it will not seem to affect us a lot because we use electricity. Because what happened in the summer season, when there is a hot day, then we use either cooler, refrigerator, air conditioner, that will help in making the temperature down, that will make us to feel cold. And during winter season, we use a room heater, we use geyser in order to
prevent us from the cold. So ultimately, these are the things which help in protecting us from the hot or the cold. Nowadays, the house is also constructed in such a way that the person should not feel very cold or hot. So you can see here that even though the temperature we are talking about, but these days we are having the facilities. We are a lot of a man-made thing, artificial things are there that will help us in providing the ease. It make the thing very easy for us to deal with the temperature, whether it is a hot temperature or that of the cold temperature, students. Okay, so this is how we can deal. Sometimes what happens, there are some objects are there, students, in which we used to feel the same kind of a temperature. Okay, same kind of a temperature, it means if suppose the two objects are kept, okay, and the temperature is same for both of them, it means they are placed at a place, they are kept at a place, and the temperature, obviously the temperature will be the room temperature, and this room temperature is same for both of them. But what do you feel when you touch that of a metal object and a wooden object is kept there? When you will touch the metal object, you will feel cold, and when you will touch a wooden object, you will not going to feel any cold. Why is it so? Even though you had kept both of the object at the same temperature, even then also you feel that both of them are giving a different kind of a temperature to us, even though both are placed at the same temperature. So why is it so? Because what happened when we touch a metal object? Metal object is what? They are a very good conductor of heat. So it will take the heat from your hand quickly, very quickly. Okay. So they used to take the heat from our hand, and that will passes through that of the metal. So as it has taken our heat from our hand become cool. Okay. What happened in case of a wood? Wood is a poor conductor of heat and heat. So ultimately, when you touch a wood, it will not make the heat to escape from our hand. The heat which is present in our hand, that will be not able to escape out when we touch a wood. But when we touch a metal, it escapes out. And the reason is the metal is what? Very good conductor of heat. So it will take that of the heat from our hand, and due to which we feel cold. In case of a wood, since it is a poor conductor, so do not allow heat to pass through them, and ultimately we do not feel cold as we have feel in that of a metal object. So keeping the object at the same temperature, even though we know that both of them are at the same temperature, but when we touch it, we find that both of them are different. One has remained hot, one has become cold. So we have understood here the topic, and that is conduction. So conduction is basically there for solid object. Now moving on, and we will see the another topic, student, and that is convection. The process of the convection is basically used for the liquid and gases. Convection. Let us try to understand the convection term. So, this transfer of heat from in liquid and gases that occur due to the convection process. So basically what happened in the convection, here the particles actually move. In case of a solid, we have seen the particles used to vibrate, but here the particles do not vibrate, but they used to move from one place to the another. That is called as the convection, students. Basically what happened here, the transfer of the particle occur from the hotter region to the colder region. That is called as the convection. So we can write it here that convection is the transfer of heat
it is a
transfer of
heat from the hotter part
from the
hotter parts of a liquid hotter parts of a liquid or a gas to its colder part to its colder part by movement of the liquid by movement of the liquid by movement of the liquid itself movement of the liquid itself okay so basically what happened here that the particles in case of the liquid or in that of the gases they are actually moving from the hotter part of the of the liquid or the gas to the colder part of that of the liquid or the gases itself that is called as the convection see what is the difference between the conduction and convection in case of a convection the particles are actually moving in case of a conduction the particles are not moving at all they will remain at their fixed position they simply used to vibrate but in case of a convection the particles are actually moving from one place to the another okay solid in case of a solid convection cannot happen because the particles are very close to each other so such kind of a movement we cannot expect in case of a solid but in case of a liquid the particles are a little bit free so they are able to move okay so this is the convection process so we have seen here that the process of the convection cannot take place in the solid question arises that does it can occur in the vacuum and if not then why so it cannot occur this process also cannot occur in the vacuum here students because in vacuum there is no particle so there is a need of a particle for the movement for the generating the convection current so let us see that how convection happens in case of the liquid convection in liquids so water is a poor conductor so it cannot transfer heat by conduction but transfer heat but it can transfer heat through the process of convection through the process of convection now see here what happened I'll tell you with the help of a diagram now you see here students what happened okay let me draw this diagram again So let me give a flame to it. So if suppose we are providing heat to it, okay, now this beaker, it consisting of a water. So what happened here, students, we are actually providing heat to it. So the lower layer of the water receives the heat first, and you know that when an object receives the heat, it expands. The water it receives heat, it expands and become lighter. And as it become lighter, what happens? It starts moving in the upward direction, right? From here, from this side also, from this side also, right? It will start moving in the upward direction. So we can say here that this is what hot water rises. This hot water, it rises. Okay, this is what this we are providing the heat to it. And this is the beaker containing water. Beaker containing water. So when we provided the heat, this layer of the heat, this layer of the water, the lower layer of the water receives the heat. Now it receives the heat, it becomes light, it expands and becomes lighter. You know that when the water receives the heat, it becomes hot, it becomes hot, it means it expands and becomes lighter, and due to which it starts moving in the upward direction. The upper layer consisting of the cold water. So what happened? If you compare the density, that which one is the denser, which one is the heavier, then that of a cold water and the hot water, we will find here that the cold water is what? It is a lighter one than that of the cold. The hot water is the lighter one than that of the cold water. Okay, so we can say here that when we supply heat to it, this hot water expands and rises up, and the cold water which is present at the upper level, it starts moving downward. So this one is moving upward and it will move downward. So this we can say that cold water sinks. So this will sink downward and the hot water rises upward. So as now when this cold water, it will reaches to the downward, again what happened? This will also receives heat, and finally due to which we can say that again it will goes in the upward direction. So what is going on here, that at first the lower level of the water, it becomes hot, rises upward, due to which the upper level of the water goes to the lower side, again goes to, it sinks downward, receives the heat, expands and again goes upward, and the upward water again comes downward, and this cycle goes on and on. And this is what? It is actually the process of the convection, in which the heat is transferred from the hotter part to the colder part of the colder part of the region, right? So it is moving from the hotter part to the colder. So this is what it is, the convection, and this is what, this is a kind of a current which is flowing in that of the beaker. So this we call as what? As a convection current. So this convection current is produced when the hot water rises up, and the cold water being heavier, it will sink down. And this whole process will continue until and unless whole of the water will receives an equal amount of a temperature or becomes equally hot. Okay, so this is what, this is how the convection in case of the liquid happens, students. Okay.
In the next class, we will going to study that how the convection in case of an air happens.